The United States has announced a deal with the European Union to resolve steel and aluminum tariff dispute. For more on this, WEON's principal diplomatic correspondent Sidhan Sibal is live with us from Rome. We'll talk about the deal later. But the G20 comes to a close today, and we have seen various leaders speak both at the forum and on the sidelines. Everyone is curious. When are we going to see or feel the impact of these talks by world leaders, or in the literal sense, some action, Sid Hunt?
Well, Eric, the G20 summit is almost over now. Of course, the declarations are awaited, and the Sherpas are expected to do briefings, including, of course, the pressers by the U.S. President Joe Biden, the German Chancellor Angela Merkel, and the French President Emmanuel Macron. Important press conferences, but in terms of the declaration, this is something keenly awaited, especially on the issue of climate change. We know that today the Glasgow climate summit begins, and the leaders will be going to Glasgow from here. And we know this includes the Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And climate has been one issue that has been dominating the agenda here at the G20. In fact, today a crucial session happened on the issue of environment. We are still awaiting the details as to what the Indian Prime Minister said in his statement during that session. But largely, what happens here, the key outcomes here at the G20 decides or helps the larger process of negotiations or consensus formation in Glasgow. But we have also seen a lot of protests, whether it's here in Rome or whether it's in Glasgow as well. But negotiators will be burning the midnight oil to make sure that they can come out with something that is realistically and practically possible by all countries, because there is a big divergence in the stance of various countries. The developing countries have been saying that yes, they consider climate change a major worry, but they also need to grow as well, and for that they need energy and they need clean technology, and for that they have been asking finance. The developed world has been saying that you need to cut down your coal intake, and this is something that is a little bit hard for countries like India and of course for China. But largely, we do expect that once the Glasgow is over, there can be some sort of declaration. But the problem is, even if the declarations are made, will there be any practical implementation or not? That is the big fear.
Sid Hunt, we are receiving reports that Prime Minister Narendra Modi has already met Spain Prime Minister Pedro Sanchez. Do we know or do we have any information about their meeting?
Well, we will be waiting for the details of what transpired during this meeting. But if you look at the larger bilaterals Indian Prime Minister have been having, he has had a whole host of bilaterals here. Only one meeting is now left with the German Chancellor Angela Merkel. And that is expected to be a much emotional meeting, given the fact that this would be most likely, I can say, the last official foreign tour of Angela Merkel under the present capacity as the Chancellor of Germany. And we have seen the personal camaraderie between the two leaders. In fact, I remember from Commonwealth Summit a few years ago, the Indian Prime Minister made it a point to land in Berlin for a few hours to meet the German Chancellor. And she has been literally the face of Europe, something we have been talking since morning, and how she has shaped the European discourse at the global stage. He met the Pope, he met the French President, he met the Italian Prime Minister Mario Draghi. But Glasgow will be another opportunity for a number of bilaterals of the Indian Prime Minister. He's having almost 10 bilaterals in Glasgow as well, including with the Indian with the new leadership of Nepal, Israel and Japan, three countries with which India has a very special relationship. He's also going to meet the leaders of Finland and many African countries as well. We know India's outreach to Africa. India is reaching out to Africa, and there are plans for the next India-Africa summit as well on the anvil.
Finally, Sid Hunt, Joe Biden and Ursula von der Leyen addressed the media at the G20 summit as it nears its close. They said that to enhance the transatlantic agenda, both the U.S. and the European Commission have decided to remove tax tariffs on steel and aluminum. What does this signify?
Well, this signifies more engagement across the pond, as they say, for Atlantic, more engagement between the two sides, whether it's Europe or America, given that there have been many differences and there has been a sense of fallout also amidst the presidency of Donald Trump. We know the body language back then, especially from the G7 summits, of Trump versus the rest of the European leaders. So that natural camaraderie between Europe and America. There are few kinks, especially after the AUKUS pact, in which Europe felt betrayed, given that France was literally left out in the lurch because of this pact between US, Britain and Australia. This summit, of course, the G20 summit, provided that ample of opportunity for in-person meeting between the US President Joe Biden and, of course, the French President Macron. In fact, the US President visited the French embassy here, which is very rare for a head of the government to visit embassy of another country and meet and hold a bilateral. So this occasion, G20, in fact, provided that much needed occasion for build up that relationship, which had in the past has suffered divergences because of many issues, AUKUS, for example. But also, while it's still the press conferences are still awaited by the French, the German and the American leadership, but China, of course, has been the elephant in the room. Of course, the Chinese president not present in the G20 summit, but China is a big worry for the West and, of course, for India as well.
Sidhan Sibal, live from Rome, Italy. Thank you very much.